So the way that the Windows architecture has evolved to support devices like HoloLens, you know, has several dimensions. First is the composition of the OS itself. And so the work that we've done on componentization for client and server, for example, you know, we've taken much further to be able to compose together just the components that are needed and that makes sense for a device that has a primarily holographic user experience, you know, enabling the same kernel that we ship for client and server, you know, to power that device and have the components that it needs, for example, you know, our XAML stack, you know, and other, you know, pieces of functionality, you know, come together in a way that makes sense for that form factor. The second way in which the NT architecture has evolved to support devices, new devices like HoloLens, you know, is in its emphasis, you know, on the modern characteristics without which that device would not be possible. So the fact that the device is light and it needs to have great battery life means we have to trim down the amount of code as much as possible, you know, that is running continuously. And so the componentization work helps there, but we also have to tune policies in new ways to achieve the promise of that device. The update experience, you know, becomes dramatically simpler when you eliminate components, you know, and that has allowed us to deliver very fast updates for that device. And then even the user model and the user experience around getting into the device, experiencing and getting out, you know, we've been able to break new ground there with the user model that, as opposed to the Control-Alt-Delete experience that you're familiar with on the desktop, really is a simple handoff from one person to another and back to be able to experience, to be able to jump between their different contexts, have all of their content and their applications, you know, right there within a shared session.